Tonight, Erika Brannock is finally home. She is the last of the Boston Marathon victims to be released from the hospital. She touched down at BWI this afternoon and talked to 11 News reporter Deborah Weiner.
A private medical jet brought Erika Brannock home at last. After 50 days in a Boston hospital, she was greeted by her inner circle of strength, friends and loved ones in Team Brannock shirts. The beloved preschool teacher from Towson acknowledged dark days in her recovery, but said it was people like these who kept her going.
I've missed my coworkers. I've missed my kids in my class. You know, everyone that's here is someone that's very near and dear to my heart. And just having them all in one room is a really special thing.
29-year-old Brannock had a portion of her left leg amputated and suffered severe damage to her right leg. She had traveled to Boston to watch her mother run in the marathon.
I just saw flashes of yellow and orange and fell back slowly and blacked out for a period of time. And then when I finally came to, I could hear the sirens and people crying and screaming. And at first, I thought that a transformer had blown.
It's amazing to see her here now, as healthy as she is and so determined. So it just feels good to be home.
Brannock, who answered all questions today, asked the media for something to help her find a California woman named Joan who came to her aid after the blast.
She started screaming for people to come and take care of me. And you know, she actually took her belt off to use as a tourniquet on my leg. And if it weren't for her, you know, screaming for everyone, I don't think I'd be alive.
Erika Brannock is eager to get on with her life in Baltimore, attending preschool graduation for her students and a wedding this weekend. She will be maid of honor. In Glen Burnie, Deborah Weiner, WBAL-TV 11 News.
A remarkable young woman.